China's pet industry is growing year by year, but many animals are being abandoned or neglected by their owners.
动物最终幸福还是要找到家嘛，就因为我只是做一个这个中间的这个流程，给它救治，然后养护，最后把它养健康了，养漂亮了，没有问题了，然后再找到主人。还是希望它有一个独立的主人，能跟主人在一起生活。Leo
Yin Lee works as a volunteer for Together Animals, an animal rights group operating mainly in Beijing. The group, together with non-members, treats and cares for unwanted and discarded pets. They've taken in 150 dogs at this shelter in Hubei province. They were about to be sold for meat or fur, but the group was just able to save them. Zhao Xinqi runs the facility. He's against the custom of eating dog and has been taking action against illegal meat sales. In May 2015, he discovered a truck loaded with dogs on a highway in Tianjin, about 200 kilometers from Beijing, heading towards the southeast. Of the 485 dogs were Tibetan Mastiffs, a popular breed that was once sold from several thousand to millions of US dollars, and considered a sound business investment.
主人200块钱就卖了一只，就是跟他一边大的dog，养了四五年的dog，说卖就卖了200块钱，我不知道就是说出于他是什么心。
Zhao followed the truck for about 5 hours. He contacted the authorities, and the dogs were rescued. The animals were crammed into small cages, emaciated from not being fed or given water. Tibetan Mastiffs were once called the dog of God in China, but following a huge boom in popularity, nearly all that remains are unwanted mongrels.